Thank you for coming for this press conference. And this whole idea of meeting the press on behalf of MIM party was to share the opinion which our party has given to the government of India and to the empowered group of ministers on the basis of the letter that was sent by the Ministry of Home Affairs. We have given to you, if I am not wrong, 4 sets. One is the letter to the Joint Secretary. The second is the background note on the stand on Telangana state issue. Third is the memorandum to the group of ministers on the formation of Telangana state. And then a legal opinion is there, which we have taken from a constitutional expert, Mr. Niranjan Reddy, on 371D. And the last set is on the Pandit Sundarlal committee report. Now let me first start by saying that the stand of MIM on the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh was we were against the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh, and we've also said to the Sri Krishna committee, I'm just reiterating what we have said in writing to the Sri Krishna committee, that is, we oppose the bifurcation, and Hyderabad, if bifurcation happens, should not be made a union territory. This has been the stand of MIM, and we will take this stand, I will take this stand to my grave. Now, Government of India, after taking a decision on the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh, a cabinet note has been passed. Whether we like it or not, the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh looks a reality. Now, I cannot tell you whether there is going to be a slip between the cup and the lip. But after the cabinet has passed a cabinet note, bifurcation looks a reality. And you might know that after the we had addressed last time we had met here in Darussalam, I had reiterated this. Now the opinion which MIM party has given to the empowered group of ministers, it will be fair on my part to say that the cabinet note, the terms of reference are clearly pointing towards that the government of India wants to make Hyderabad as a union territory, or they want to make it short of union territory. And why do I say that? Is because if you read the cabinet note, if you read the terms of reference, there is no clarity on Hyderabad. Whether Hyderabad constitutes a revenue district, whether Hyderabad constitutes the GHMC limits, whether Hyderabad constitutes the HMDL area, or fourth, the Hyderabad constitutes Hyderabad an agglomeration area, which the Census Department of India takes. Second point is that there is no clarity in the cabinet note and in the terms of reference. That why is it that the State Public Service Commission has to be one? Thirdly, there is no clarity on why a separate high court for the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh cannot be formed immediately. The fourth point is if you read the background note of Home Ministry given by the Home Ministry to the group of ministers, on page number 37, to be very precise, on page number 37, it says, it talks about bringing in education and employment for Hyderabad within this whole area. So because of these 5 points, we suspect, and our suspicion is based on the cabinet note, based on the terms of reference, based on the background note which the Home Ministry has given to Empowered Group of Ministers, that Government of India is contemplating to make Hyderabad either Union Territory or short of Union Territory. Now what is the stand of MIM party? From day one we have been saying we oppose the Union Territory status to Hyderabad. This has been the consistent stand of MIM party. We cannot accept Hyderabad as Union Territory. We cannot accept Hyderabad with law and order, revenue, municipal administration, education and health with the Government of India. We want Hyderabad to be given to, if a Telangana state is coming into existence, without any condition. Without any condition, Hyderabad should be given to the Telangana state. This is what MIM said to the Sri Krishna Committee. This is what I have been saying publicly. This is what I have said in the parliament. This is what I have said with the interaction with all of you. The third point is law and order. You take law and order. In that note which we have given, there are nearly 4,000 odd vacancies in Hyderabad City Police. There are nearly 3,000 vacancies in the Saibarabad Police Commissionerate. Whenever a festival happens in Hyderabad, whether it is any festival, the city police has to mobilize forces from throughout Andhra Pradesh for the maintenance of peace and security of the city. Now let us assume that a Telangana state is formed and law and order is taken away. Where will you get the forces from? Second point. Tomorrow you have two chief ministers over here. And what will be the position of the police? Third point, which is our biggest apprehension, that this will lead to miscarriage of justice against the Muslims. Because as it is, there is lot of bias among some of police officers against the Muslim community and the Dalits. So anyone who is made the commissioner of police, Hyderabad and Saibarabad will not be there. We suspect that a commissionerate of both will be formed, and this commissioner of police would be the super chief minister. Would be the super chief minister. He will be more powerful than the residual chief minister or residual state of Andhra Pradesh or the chief minister of Telangana. And it is very unfortunate. It is very unfortunate. I fail to understand what sort of vision or thinking these Congress leaders of Telangana have. They are saying, okay, we are willing to give law and order to Government of India. With respect to them, I would like to say to all these Congress leaders who are accepting that we are willing to give law and order to Government of India. Number one, they don't have any political stakes in Hyderabad, either in the GHMC area or in the Hyderabad district. These leaders, they are not leaders who are saying, but they are jokers. They don't know the reality of Hyderabad. They don't know the miscarriage of justice which has happened to Muslims, which happens to Muslims day in, day out. Whether it is Makkah Masjid bomb blast or any other incident. And they have no political interest. And all these Congress leaders of Telangana who are saying that we will accept law and order to be given, revenue to be given, municipal administration to be given, they are only very keen and eager to become the chief minister only. They don't care about all these things. That is why we strongly oppose a move which has been given. And I'm also surprised by the note that has been given by
the Telangana Joint Action Committee also.
Verbally, Kodandaram says 2 years, but in his note, he does not talk about it. The Telangana Congress, MLCs, they are saying, okay, give away 10 years. What is this? And then the argument given is that people from Sima Andhra live in Hyderabad. That is not right. If that argument is, if it is taken on its face value, then Sima Andhra people live in Rangareddy district. Sima Andhra people live in Nalgunda. Sima Andhra people live in Nizamabad. Sima Andhra people live in Khammam. If that is the argument, then I am forced to say, let law and order of all these 4 districts be taken away by Government of India. Let all the IPS officers who are going to be appointed in Saibarabad, in Rangareddy, in Nizamabad, in Khammam be appointed by Government of India in Nalgunda. What will Mr. Jana Reddy do then? What will Mr. Sudarshan Reddy of Nizamabad do? What will the Khammam leaders do? So that is why we are saying law and order has to be given to the state of Telangana. And if the state of Telangana cannot provide security to the people of Sima Andhra, then use Article 356 and throw away that government. Throw away that government. Because to provide security to life and limb of an Indian citizen is the fundamental duty of a government. And I am surprised that all this argument is only going around Hyderabad and people of Sima Andhra. What about Muslims? What about Dalits? What about Christians? Our apprehension is very true that in a separate state of Telangana, definitely Sangh Parivar and BJP will grow. The bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh will only help the RSS. And in that post-bifurcation scenario, when Sangh Parivar will become more powerful, our apprehensions are true. Who will address our apprehensions? And whether we like it or not, the police always works under the political executive. It is fine to take a very moralistic and arguments and Prakash Singh argument. It is fine. But the reality is this. And who do we go and say that tomorrow if another Makkah Masjid miscarriage of justice happens, who do I go and say? Who do I go and say? Taking away municipal administration will destroy Hyderabad forever. That will destroy Hyderabad because the Telangana state will not invest in Hyderabad. The other state would say, no, we are going afterwards sometime. Why would we invest in Hyderabad? So Hyderabad will be destroyed economically. Thirdly, we want a separate high court to be created immediately for the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh. Because a demand is there from the Sima Andhra people, immediately High Court should be divided. We oppose the arrangement which is again being proposed by government, by Dr. Manmohan Singh government, that a High Court on the lines of Chandigarh and for Punjab and Haryana should be continued. No, we are opposing that. We don't want that to happen. Let a clean separation be made. And for the protection of Sima Andhra people, we are committed towards their protection. We will stand with them. And that is why in that note we have proposed that the Sima Andhra people should be given protection under Article 29 of our constitution. That is, they should be treated as linguistic minorities. The State Minorities Commission of Telangana should include the Sima Andhra people as linguistic minorities. That is the constitutional safeguard which we are proposing for those people. And as far as another proposal which we have made is that let both the chief ministers, both the opposition leaders from both the states sit down and decide which IPS officer should be put in Hyderabad or surrounding. That is a reasonable thing which can be done. But taking away the right and making the governor the responsible person, no, that is not right. I would say that any politician of Telangana from Congress party who is aspiring to become chief minister
If you have any integrity left, if you have any self-esteem towards that region, oppose this move. Don't be selfish that only you want to become chief minister. That is why we are going to barter. They don't have a right to barter about Hyderabad. You don't have a right to talk about Hyderabad. You don't have any political interest in Hyderabad. You cannot decide my future. You cannot be master of my destiny. If that is the case, then Nalgunda also, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Khammam, everyone, they are not to be taken by government of India. Another third point in that argument, we are opposing this joint, this common capital issue. No, we don't want a common capital. Why common capital? Let Hyderabad Mandal be called as a working or an interim capital. That Hyderabad Mandal area or the Hyderabad Assembly Constituency or Jubilee Assembly Constituency be called an interim or a working capital. And if and when the reorganization bill is brought in Parliament, it is the duty of the Government of India that they must say in that bill which is going to be the capital of the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh. They must say that clearly. If Government of India sits over there and decides 10 years, then they can decide this also. What will be the capital of residuary state? And union ministers like Mr. Chiranjeevi, like Mr. Kanse Saab, who is Karnataka ki MP, J.D. Silam. These people are saying no for the safety of this area. Then I would say, tomorrow if a Telangana state comes into existence, we need to import and export. I would tell the BPCC president, let him be ready to make Vizag a union territory. Kakinada also union territory. Because import and export has to be done. Our Hindu brothers from Telangana would like to go to Tirupati for their security. Let Tirupati also be made union territory. Can this argument be accepted? If this argument cannot be accepted, then my argument has a point. Because tomorrow, from Kakinada, from Vishakhapatnam, import-export has to happen. Telangana will be a landlocked area. And these people who want to become chief minister, as we say in Urdu, they are ready to become a dula. They are ready to sit on a horse and dance. No fear about Hyderabad or Telangana. These are the arguments on which we are opposing law and order, revenue and municipal administration and this concept of joint capital. Let it be called an interim working capital of Hyderabad Mandal. The same respect can be given to the chief minister of that residuary state. We can create a mechanism. But why is it that the government of India wants to take over law and order? Why is it the government of India wants to ensure that the High Court of Residuary State remains over here? These are the points which we have highlighted. Now coming to the second question of the geographical area, MIM has proposed that Royal Telangana, it doesn't look it will happen, which we have given to Sri Krishna Committee. That is why we are proposing that in the interest of justice, that in the interest of justice, Anantapur and Karnool should be added to the state of Telangana. It is in the interest of justice. Justice demands that Anantapur and Karnool should be added to Telangana. And why? Because Anantapur has the most backward parameters for socio-economic development. And I am of the opinion, our parties of the opinion, if bifurcation happens, the worst sufferers will be Rayalaseema region. You cannot deny that. That will be the worst sufferers. And I can understand the angst of Mr. Naidu, Mr. Kiran Kumar Reddy, and Mr. Jagan Mohan Reddy, because they represent from Rayalaseema. I can understand their angst. If Anantapur and Karnool are added to state of Telangana, we will be solving the water issue. If we don't add them, then we will have water wars. Water issue will be solved. this claim of Hyderabad, the so-called claim of Hyderabad will be, you know, it will come down. Thirdly, the Rajasthani state of Andhra Pradesh can form their capital in coastal Andhra. That also they will be free to do that. So we have proposed that Karnool and Anantapur should be added to the state of Telangana. And it should be, if a bifurcation happens, in inverted commas I am saying, if it happens, then 10 plus 2 should be added. Common capital, as I said, is misconceived, and UT is misconceived. All those things I have mentioned to you. And then another issue is about law and order, also I have mentioned to you. In terms of reference, again, now we come to MIM has proposed that Pranahita Chivalla should also be given a national status. Pranahita Chivalla should also be given national status, because we have mentioned in that note, I don't want to go into the details, the requirement of drinking water for Hyderabad in the next 15-20 years is going to be very high. So even after the phase 3 of Krishna is covered, we will not be providing the demand that is there. Singareni collieries, we have proposed that the state of Telangana should be the joint owner along with Government of India. Regarding powers, terms of reference number 7, power supply in Hyderabad, MIM party has proposed to the Government of India that a special power project for the city of Hyderabad should be given under public-private partnership, and also to sanction 2 ultra-mega power projects of 4,000 megawatt for Hyderabad. Now, we have also given Hyderabad economic profile, and we have also talked about all these, the revenue that is coming. Now, coming to distribution of assets and liabilities, MIM party says that the present AP Bhavan in New Delhi and was given in lieu of Hyderabad House. Hyderabad House was built by the Nizam, and because of Hyderabad House was taken by Government of India, AP Bhavan was given and a vacant land was given. So this present AP Bhavan and that land has to come to the new state, because these are the assets which were there before the new state came into existence. So you cannot say that a Rajasthani state has a right over it, because these were there before Andhra Pradesh was formed. Now, distribution of employees on terms of reference number 9, that also we have talked about. I have told you what Public Service Commission immediately should come into existence for the new state. Now, as far as 371D is concerned, I would like to request you that we have given a legal opinion wherein the esteemed lawyer Mr. Niranjan Reddy in his opinion says that for 371D you do not require a constitutional amendment, because in his wisdom, in his knowledge of law, which I have high respect for him, and that is why we have taken his opinion, he says, and which I also concur, that when Meghalaya was formed, 371 was not amended. Assam had that special provision. When state of Maharashtra and Gujarat came into existence, again 371(2) was not touched. So I feel that this argument that it will lead to constitutional amendment is a specious argument. It does not hold any water. Now, let me conclude by once again addressing the concerns of Muslims of both the regions. Believe me, bifurcation will hurt Muslims very badly. Bifurcation will also hurt people of Rayalaseema very badly. Our fear of Sangh Parivar going in Telangana is on well-founded empirical political evidence. It is going to happen. Unfortunately, this whole Telangana movement has not thrown new leadership, has not thrown progressive leadership, has not thrown such new leaders have not come. So again, we are stuck with the old leadership, and this will really help the BJP to get stronger, RSS to get stronger. We are demanding that if and when the new state is formed, the language of Urdu, it deserves justice by Government of India. A language which has played such an important part in the freedom movement has completely been forgotten. Telugu language is getting one more state. Yes, the dialect will be different, but the language is the same. So we are proposing that in the state of Telangana, if it is formed, Urdu should be given the first language status along with Telugu. That has to be done. The Government of India must say this clearly, that Urdu will be given its rightful place in the new state, and it will be given the first language status along with Telugu. Reservation to Muslims of both the regions should continue. The budget which is being promised, it should be increased for the development of minorities. And I hope, and we have proposed, that the Government of India must implement the Prevention of Communal Violence Bill must be brought in both the states. Because our apprehension of Sangh Parivar growing in the new state is very much there. We have also proposed a minority sub-plan. And now coming to the higher educational opportunities, we have given you the data. The argument that has been given by the Home Ministry in the note which they have given to the group of ministers is wrong. It is completely wrong. I don't know why Home Ministry is doing, I mean, why are they lying through their teeth? When it comes to medical education, they are saying how many hospitals are there in Telangana and how many hospitals are there in other regions. And they are saying excluding Hyderabad. How can you exclude Hyderabad from Telangana? In your own cabinet note, you are saying Hyderabad is part of Telangana. Then in your note, you are saying excluding. So this is a wrong argument being given by the Government of India. And we have given you all number of colleges which clearly says that this argument that X region or Y region will be deprived is wrong. And those districts which do not have universities, the government can immediately announce and establish universities which can cater to the needs of education requirement, and there will be no threat whatsoever to the people of Simandra. We will stand with them. I am standing with them in the interest of justice, not because I want their vote. I don't want their vote also. I don't want, even if they do decide not to vote for me, it's not a big issue. But we'll stand with them. And these are the, in gist, I have just tried to tell you the points which MIM has written to the Government of India. And this is what we have said. And if there are any points or any questions which you want to ask me, I'm free to answer them. Thank you. To the all the ministers and empowered group of ministers and to the joint secretary. Now, if and when a meeting is called, definitely we'll go to the meeting. Definitely we'll go to the meeting. And you know, Congress party honeymoon is finishing in Telangana. The honeymoon is slowly finishing. So I hope they realize that the grass is growing under their feet. I have succeeded in provoking you. You tell me how is it possible then? You tell me how is it possible? That is what we want you to realize. That tomorrow if a new state comes into existence, will it be right on a person to live in Vizag or Srikakulam to come down here? That is not right. And please understand that government of India should realize that this is not Chandigarh. It has no geographical contiguity. It has no geographical contiguity whatsoever, whether you like it or not. That is why we are proposing an interim or a working capital, because all those offices are located in Khairatabad Mandal or in Khairatabad Assembly Constituency. For the working of that administration, that can be done. And immediately, these can be shifted. And I fail to understand that when Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru did not agree to give law and order to, or did not make union territory or short of union territory for Mumbai, for God's sake, Congress party should accept the legacy of Pandit Nehru. If Indira Gandhi in her wisdom decided not to give away, take law and order when Meghalaya was created, for God's sake, I mean, these are the leaders of who you want to die for them, who you asked vote for people to vote in their name, to live up to their legacy, live up to their statement which you have made in past. आपके क्वेश्चन में कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन, एक तो आप यूनाइटेड आंध्रा ही बोल रहे हैं, बोल रहे किसके एजुटेशन करो, बोलिए आप, मैं करता हूँ।
नहीं, यूनाइटेड आंध्रा के वास्ते भी नहीं करें।
अच्छा, नहीं करें। नहीं, हम लोग बहुत कुछ कर सकते और करेंगे ईश्वर रेड्डी साहब, आप मुतमइन रहिए। और करने का जो तरीका है, आपके बार पब्लिक जो है खाली सीटी बजाती, वो सीटी बजाने का काम हम कर देंगे। पोलिंग बूथ में जाके दबा देना बटन, वो काम को तैयार, वो भी एक तरीका है। अब मालूम हो जाता ना, घोड़ा मैदान आ गया है, 4-5 महीने में सब चीज आगे है। और जितने लोग जो एग्री कर रहे हैं ये कॉमन कैपिटल, उनको हम बताएंगे उनका क्या हाल होने वाला है। तेलंगाना के लिए ईश्वर रेड्डी साहब, आप भी तेलंगाना के हैं ना, आप तो तेलंगाना को सपोर्ट भी करते हैं, आप बोले मेरे कई मरतबा, आप एक मरतबा मेरे को बोलिए कि तेलंगाना के लिए एक ही ग्रोथ इंजन है, वो हैदराबाद। एक ही ग्रोथ, आप यूजर लाइक इट और नॉट, इट्स ओनली ग्रोथ इंजन फॉर तेलंगाना। Now, if you are going to scuttle that, what justice are you doing? Why are you creating this state then? You are going to take away law and order, you are going to take away revenue, you want to take away municipal administration, you want to create HMDA or GHMC, and why? What is this? ये क्या नाना की दुकान पे मामू की फातिया देने का काम कर रहे हैं आप? क्या आपके घर की जायदाद है, आप बांटेंगे दिल्ली में बैठ के, या गांधी भवन में बैठ के, या फिर मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर बनना चाह रहा हूं दे दो ले लो, मैं चीफ मिनिस्टर बनना चाह रहा हूं ये ले लो। अरे भाई, अगर आप चीफ मिनिस्टर बनना चाह रहे तो फिर नलगुंडा को भी लॉ ऑर्डर कर देना, आप चीफ मिनिस्टर बनना चाह रहे तो रंगारेड्डी को भी कर देना, देखेंगे क्या बोलते हैं उस पर, वहां भी सीमांध्र के लोग हैं ना। इसीलिए इट इज रॉन्ग, इट डज नॉट मेक जस्टिस, ये बिल्कुल ही नहीं हो सकता। तेलंगाना आप बना रहे, उसका तरक्की आपकी जिम्मेदारी, बच्चा आप पैदा कर रहे, मैंने पैदा कर रहा हूं, आप बच्चा पैदा कर रहे, आप बच्चे को पैदा कर रहे तो कुछ तो खाने को, जिंदा रहने को, माल न्यूट्रिशन से मर जाएगा उन्हें, स्टील बॉर्न होगा अगर हैदराबाद को ले लेंगे तो, आप वो उनके ऊपर जिम्मेदारी है। इसीलिए हम बोल रहे हैं भाई, बच्चा आप पैदा कर रहे, आप मम्मी डैडी है उसके, तो अच्छा करो उसको। मैं तेलंगाना कांग्रेस के लीडर को तनकीद कर रहा हूं, ज्वाइंट एक्शन कमेटी भी कर रहा हूं, तेलंगाना एमएलसी पे भी कर रहा हूं, सब पे कर रहा हूं कि इन लोगों का नंबर वन ये लोग इशू नहीं समझ रहे। नहीं, टीआरएस का देखिए, श्री कृष्णा कमेटी को जब मैं रिप्लाई लिख के दिया तो उस वक्त आप क्यों ने पूछे मेरे, कोई कॉमन क्या है क्या उसमें हमारे में, हमारा एक अलग स्टेटेड पोजिशन है उसके ऊपर हम कायम है। ये जो डिलीवर जो वादे कर रहे, ये वादा और वफा की जो बातें हो रही है, मालूम हो जाता 5 दिसंबर को क्या होने वाला है। बिल तो आने दीजिए, किस फॉर्म में आएगा बिल, क्या होगा, इसे सब मालूम होगा। हमारे से आप पूछे, मैं आपको गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया को बता दिए। आप याद रखिए मेरी इस बात को कि बाइफर्केशन अगर होगा तो सबसे बड़ा नुकसान मुसलमानों को, क्रिश्चियंस को, दलित को और रायलसीमा के लोगों को होने जा रहा है, कि कोई डिनाई नहीं कर सकता इस बात। इसीलिए हम बोल रहे हैं कि दो डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स को ऐड करो आप। अगर कोई तेलंगाना के इरिगेशन एक्सपर्ट है तो उनसे बैठ के पूछ लो आप कि पानी का मसला हल हो सकता। ये जो उनमें जो फीलिंग है कि हैदराबाद चले आ रहा, वो हैदराबाद उनको मिलता, और आंध्रा के लोग जो है अपना कैपिटल बना सकते। अब देखना यह है कि ये क्या होने वाला है। हर थोड़े दिन को कभी बोल रहे एक मीटिंग होंगी, फिर बोल रहे दो दो मीटिंग होंगे, क्या होता नहीं मालूम। अब देखेंगे, घोड़ा मैदान आगे है, क्या करते क्या नहीं करते अब मालूम होगा। यस, डिविजन ऑफ रायलसीमा इज बिकॉज इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ रायलसीमा। We will continue to fight over there. We will continue to get in more ground over there. And people of that region accept. They have told to me that it is only you and CPM which had clarity on this issue. हम तो ऐसा नहीं कर रहे ना कि हैदराबाद में एक बात बोल रहे, हैदराबाद के एयरपोर्ट पे आधी बात बोलते, दिल्ली के एयरपोर्ट जाके पूरा चेंज कर लेते। हम तो ऐसा नहीं करें, हम तो बोले जो हैदराबाद में बोले वो दिल्ली में भी बोले, और वो हमारा एक कंसिस्टेंट स्टैंड है एमआईएम और सीपीएम का। तो जहां तक एमआईएम के स्टैंड की क्रेडिबिलिटी है वो वहां की आवाम को मालूम कि ये लोग सही बोल रहे थे, हम शुरू से बोल रहे थे, और जब नहीं समझे आफत आगे लोगों पर, अब जब समझे। Referendum in constitution is not allowed. There is no scope. Now, I have 7 members of assembly in Hyderabad district. That in itself, I am the biggest stakeholder. I am the son of this place. Aur main marunga to inshallah ya to Madine mein marunga ya phir yahi zameen mein jaunga main. To mere se badhkar dawa kiska ho sakta hai Hyderabad ke upar? तो हम ये बोल रहे हैं, भैया क्या करने जा रहे हैं आप, हैदराबाद इकोनॉमिकली तबाह हो जाएगा। और ये जो आर्गुमेंट आप दे रहे हैं कि नहीं इतना पैसा आता, गलत है ये। जो कमर्शियल टैक्स आता, जितने गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के जैसा मिसाल ऑयल कंपनीज है, जैसा स्टेट बनेगा वो लोग दूसरे स्टेट में जाएंगे तो कहां हमारे टैक्स आएगा, तो टैक्स तो कम होगा। इसीलिए हम बोल रहे कि भाई समझो इस बात को कि ये एक ही ग्रोथ इंजन है। Telangana state cannot survive on the royalty of Singareni collieries. Without Hyderabad, दो दिन स्टेट नहीं चल सकता। ये जो लोग चीफ मिनिस्टर बनने के ख्वाब देख रहे, इनकी गाड़ी में पेट्रोल ले लेंगे, वो खाली नाम के चीफ मिनिस्टर रहेंगे, इनको पैदल जाना पड़ेगा अपने ऑफिस को। तो ये इसीलिए समझने की बहुत बड़ी जरूरत है। In fitness of things, I have to first send an opinion. I have to first reply to the terms of reference. And what action needs to be done in future, definitely I'll share with you. I will speak to my friend like Ishwar Reddy sir, baat karenge, aap logon sabse baat karke, you know, kaisa aage leke jana, kya karna, bahut se laab hai, karenge barabar. Lekin hamara ek point hum rakhe to road pe bhi jayenge, court ko bhi jayenge, aur polling booth pe bhi jayenge. Teen cheezan hone wale hain. रोड पे भी होगा, कोर्ट में भी जाएंगे और पोलिंग बूथ में भी होगा। अब उसके बाद देखिए क्या क्या होगा। नहीं, किरण कुमार रेड्डी साहब का मैं आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड हिज एंगस्ट, हम समझ सकते हैं, उन रायलसीमा से आते और हम समझ सकते हैं उनकी तकलीफ, क्योंकि वो इलाका बहुत परेशान कुल हालात से गुजरने वाला है, तो मैं समझ सकता हूं उनकी तकलीफ। के पैदा करके मेरे गोद में नहीं डालना हैदराबाद के, आप पैदा करें तो उसको ताकत दो, सब चीज करो। ये आपके लिए ये ऐसा नहीं है कि नहीं आप अडॉप्ट कर लो, मैं अडॉप्ट करने तैयार नहीं हूं भाई, एडॉप्शन का आदि। ये क्या है, आप दो पूरा अख्तियार दो, वो बच्चे को ताकतवर बनाओ, आप फलने दो, फूलने दो, ताकतवर रहने दो। भाई आप कुछ भी नहीं करेंगे, नहीं हम दे दिए, अरे दे दिए बोल तो कहूंगा भाई, हो सकता हो। अब देखिए, अब मालूम होता आपको और मेरे को अब क्या करने वाले हैं, क्या नहीं करने वाले हैं, तो कोई छुपने वाली बात तो नहीं, आप ना तो नहीं छोड़ने वाले, मेरे को मालूम, आप तो खामोश नहीं बैठते, मालूम होता अभी। एनीथिंग एल्स सर, प्लीज बोलिए सर। विल कंटिन्यू, फ्रेंडशिप्स आर मेड एंड फ्रेंडशिप विल कंटिन्यू। द बॉटम लाइन इज that in the present political environment of our country, anyone who stands to oppose Modi, people, you and me will call him a friend, who wants to join with Modi, then he becomes a pariah. Simple as that. जो वहां के intellectuals है, जो वहां के बहुत से इंपॉर्टेंट पोजिशंस में इन्फ्लुएंस करने के, मेरे को कई मरतबा आके मुलाकात की, मुझसे बात करे, वहां के पॉलिटिशियंस भी है, मैं उनका नाम नहीं ले सकता क्योंकि बातें ऐसी होती कि ऑफ द रिकॉर्ड होती, तो यकीनन उनका भी ख्याल यही है कि आप जो शुरू से बोल रहे रायलसीमा को ज्वाइन करो, हम उसके साथ हैं। फिर अनंतपुर कर्नूल की जो बात करें, वो बोले वो भी ठीक है। अब एक्सेप्ट करते हैं नहीं करते, देखिए मेरे से जब टर्म्स ऑफ रेफरेंस में पूछ रहे तो मैं लिख के दे रहा हूं उसको। अब क्या होगा क्या नहीं हो सकता, तो जाहिर है वहां के लोग मेरे को काउंटर भी कर सकते, नहीं हम और नहीं चाह रहे, हम अग्री नहीं करते, अग्री कर सकते, उनको इख्तियार है बोलने। अब बीजेपी क्या करने वाली है नहीं करने वाली है मेरे को नहीं मालूम, मैं कैसा बोल सकता हूं बीजेपी के बारे में, और हमारा तो एक कंसिस्टेंट स्टैंड है, हम उसको रिइटरेट कर रहे हैं, कोई नई बात हम नहीं कर रहे, आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स कोई नहीं है, जो बात जो हम शुरू से कर रहे हैं वो रिइटरेट कर रहे हैं। Now, this question I can only answer when we cross that bridge. We don't know what will be the result that will come, what result will be thrown by the people of India. And one thing I'm sure, that inshallah ta'ala the people of India will support and strengthen those political parties which stand for secularism and pluralism, which is the ethos of this country and which binds this country. Okay, sir, thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you.